Right. Okay. Hi, everyone. I just want to take this time before we get started to make sure the audio is going okay. This is our very, very first live stream. So I'm really excited to be able to bring this to you. And I just want to make sure that you can type in the chat if you can hear me well. If not, I can try to find out some other audio options. Hello. Hey, everyone. Thank you so much for joining me. I'm so excited. It's going to be really, really fun. I have my lab coat on and everything. Hear me? All right. Awesome. So we'll just wait a couple more moments when more people start filing in. Awesome. I love being able to see everyone's comments. So today this segment's going to be more interactive. So we want you to comment. We want you to give suggestions. It's going to be a little bit of a question and answer period. So sometimes I'll ask some questions and I would love to hear your feedback and what you think is happening with the reactions. Voss Water. So far so good. Awesome. Perfect. I'm glad I could see everyone's comments. This is going to be really, really great. So we'll just wait a couple more minutes. So we will be streaming hopefully every weekday starting at 11 a.m. So every weekday you can check us out on this YouTube channel. We'll have more demos, more live streams so everyone can participate. And some of them even at home you might be able to do if you have your parents' supervision and permission. So cool. If it looks like I'm staring off on the side, it's just, I'm just looking at the comments there. Awesome. Cool. So how's everyone doing? Everyone's at home, following social distancing rules, washing your hands, staying healthy. Thank you. I like my lab coat too. Thanks very much. Awesome. Tuning in from York. Great to have you here. It's going to be really exciting. Okay, let's see. From Actua, welcome, Emily. Thanks for tuning in. All right. So just a couple of moments. But yeah, this is our very first live stream, so there might be some technical difficulties here and there, but we're all gonna work through this all together. And it's gonna be a great experience. So if in any time my audio cuts out, just let me know in the comments and I'll get to fixing that. But right now I think everyone's saying that they can hear me quite well, which is really good. Awesome. Everyone's able to hear me. Well, it's 11 o'clock, so we can get started. And as more people come in, we will be able to tell them a bit more information. Awesome. So let's get started. Hey, everyone. My name is Sam, and I am from Gearing Up. And I'm one of the workshop instructors from Gearing Up. And as you know, everyone is quarantined at home. We want to be healthy and safe, but also be able to learn some science. So that's why we're bringing this online stream. And I'm so excited to be announcing that we will be streaming every day at 11 o'clock. And you can find us right here, right on our YouTube channel. And we'll be doing lots of demos, awesome, fun STEM activities. Some of them, like I said, you can even try at home. If you have your parents' permission and their supervision, you will be able to try some of these at home. And we'll make sure it's clear about that. Okay, so to start off today, we're going to be talking about explosions and implosions. Many of you have heard about what an explosion is, but what's an implosion? If I can get people to comment in the comment section about what they think an explosion or an implosion is, Then we can have a little interactive portion. So we want to talk a little bit about that, and we'll talk about the science behind some of these things. And it's okay if you don't know what an explosion or implosion is. We'll go through all of this together, and we'll learn, and we'll have a really, really fun time. So I can't wait to see what you type in the comments about what you think an explosion or an implosion is. It's when something blows up. Yeah, awesome. So an explosion is when something blows up. I saw that in the comment. Perfect. So we see that a lot in science when we do science experiments. When things explode, it means that, exactly, it blows up. We usually see fire, we hear a loud sound, things usually get, you know, shot away from each other. And these are just some pictures that I have that show science experiments exploding. Sometimes as a science experiment explodes, you don't want it to explode, but sometimes that's what you want to do. And today we're going to be doing an implosion. So I see some people commenting in the comments, an implosion is when something collapses. And that's exactly right. An implosion is when something collapses in on itself. So let's take a look. Today we're going to be doing an implosion reaction on a can right here. But the cool thing is, I'm not the one that's going to be crushing the can. The air around me is going to be crushing the can. So let me say that again. I'm not going to be crushing the can myself. The air around me is going to crush it. And that's going to make it implode. So I want to show you that right now. And we're going to do this twice. And each time I want you to notice the little things that I'm doing and why they happen and the science behind that. All right. So first things first, whenever we do any science experiment, don't forget, we need to have a safety check. We want to make sure that we have our lab coats on so our clothes don't get dirty. We have our safety glasses on, okay? And today I'm gonna be working with some fire right over here, as you can see. So I'm gonna need some tongs, okay? So let me go ahead and get some materials prepared. And in the meantime, if you can comment any questions you have or how's the stream going for you, just let me know in the comments. I'll be right back. Alrighty, so what I have here are just very basic things, okay? And as I'm doing this, I want to talk a little bit about the states of matter. So what do you know about states of matter? What are the three states of matter? So let me know in the comments while I prepare the materials here. What are the three states of matter? Thank you, Swati, for the great question. Can you do this at home? Only if you have your parents next to you and your parents' permission, and preferably your parents are the ones doing it, because we are working with fire. So if your parents are, if you have your parents' permission, then you should be fine. So we have water. Awesome. So I see the three states of matter: solid, liquid, and gas. So I'm going to pour some water. Okay. That is going to be liquid. So the particles in a liquid are not as tightly packed as particles in a solid. So particles in the liquid can flow around, they can move. We've all, you know, had in contact with water and liquids. And now, as the comments say, solid. And solid is the ice. So particles in a solid are more tightly packed together. They don't move around as much. They have lower energy. And then now I have some hot water right here. So the hot water has steam. And steam is the last state of matter, gas, of water. So let me just show you this diagram right here. You have solid, liquid, and gas, and you can see the particles moving at a different speed and have different spaces between them. If you have more heat and more energy introduced, you can turn water from a liquid into a gas in steam. And if you cool it down, if you take away the energy, makes it less energy, you can turn steam into liquid and then into solid, which is the ice. And I'm going to be doing, in a way, we're going to be turning liquid water into gas in this can here, in this fire, and I'm going to turn it upside down into this water, and we are going to see what happens. If you predict what's going to happen, you can write it in the comments, talk with each other, see what you think might happen. I'm so excited to show you this. So I'm going to pour some hot water here. There's some steam coming out, but not enough. We want to make it a little bit hotter. So if you can see, just a little bit, enough to cover the bottom. Ooh, very hot. And then I'm going to fire up the propane tank right here, okay? The stove. So that's why we need to make sure that we have our parent supervision. Oops. Okay, alrighty. So I got all my safety gear on. There you go. Fire is very, very hot and very dangerous. So let's be careful, okay? Let's do this. So as I am heating the can up, I'm trying to wait until the fire gives it enough energy so that the water inside there is going to boil. And water boils, it changes state into gas. So if you can see, there's already some steam coming out. There's already some steam coming out. So the water is being turned into gas. And now I'm going to flip it upside down in this water, the ice water here. And we're going to see what happens, okay? Make sure you don't blink because it's going to happen really quick. Oh, wow. That was awesome. So if you couldn't tell, the can completely crushed itself. We saw an implosion. Isn't that crazy? I promise you, I didn't squeeze it with my tongs. The can imploded on itself. Why is that? So keep what we just talked about in mind. We have the three states of matter. And now I'm going to introduce a little bit more information to describe why this happened. Okay, and I'm going to let one of my two favorite scientists in the world explain this that happens in real life. Okay, it's from the Mythbusters. They're awesome. So here we go. Let's hear them say it.
All right, there's a guy. He's tasked with cleaning out one of those tanker cars on a train that holds liquid, and he's using a steam cleaner. So he's steam cleaning the whole thing, and of course, as he's doing that, he's warming it up, and it starts to rain. So he caps off the tanker car and walks away. The cooling rain causes the steam to contract, and as the myth goes, the train car crushes itself.
From a vacuum.
Exactly.
But first...
Right. So did everyone catch that? Wasn't that cool? Huge train tanker, right? And as someone was steam cleaning it, it was increasing the gases on the inside. But when they capped it off and rain started falling and it got colder on the outside, then the steam cleaner got crushed pretty much by air pressure. Did everyone catch that word? Air pressure. What is air pressure? I want you to comment in the comments in there to tell me what have you heard in your life that relates to air pressure. Okay? So anything that you see in your everyday life, something that relates to air pressure. I want to see some ideas. I'm going to read through the comments. Was the train car insured? I sure hope it was. That was a really expensive tanker, huh? Implosion, awesome. You've all guessed some awesome things. Implosion, yeah, everyone saw the can implode. Awesome. So some things in life, exactly. So we hear a plane needs air pressure. Air pressure of a tire, exactly. Air pressures in airplanes, yeah. So let me show you this diagram here. So there's many forms of air pressure around us. We have air pressures in our tires that needs to keep the car running. So air pressure just means the force that air exerts because of the particles. I'll explain more, but here are some ideas. In order for a plane to fly, you need to have a correct balance of air pressure so that you can generate a lift force in order to bring the plane up. And also, inside the cabin of a plane, you need to be able to have air pressure from the inside so that the plane doesn't get crushed as it goes higher and higher in altitude. And also, formation of clouds as water evaporates because it's hot. Then it goes higher and higher in the air, and with lower pressure, that'll make it condense. Keep that word in mind, condense, condensation. This is going to be what we're talking about, pressure and condensation. And another example for air pressure, you see this huge tanker being crushed as the Mythbusters explained it. So how did this can actually get crushed? By air pressure, right? So if we think about it right here, when we heated the can up, there was some water inside. And you see on the first diagram, a lot of the gas particles are moving very, very quickly. And they were bouncing on the sides of the walls of the can really fast. A lot of the gas was escaping, actually. And this actually creates sort of low pressure environment on the inside. But since the top is open, we could still what we call in science equilibrium with the air around us. However, when I tipped the can upside down into the water, that creates a seal. That creates a seal inside the low pressure environment in the can. And as the gases inside the can cool, what happens is condensation. So gases from steam actually condense, lose energy, and form a liquid. They form almost like a cloud. So if we go back to here, we see more energy when we heat it up, and when we cool it down, less energy takes up less space. And because of that, because water droplets now, not gas, because it cools down, water droplets now take up less space and exert less pressure, less of a pushing force on the sides of the walls. So atmospheric pressure around us, atmospheric pressure is just a term that we use to say all the air particles around us in the air that are bouncing against us and pushing on us, that is actually what crushed the can because the air pressure inside was lower, okay? And we're gonna try that again. So this time, I want you to notice something cool. As I take this can up, you can see some water dripping out, huh? And that was the water that was inside the can. So why is that? I want to introduce another scientific principle. So keep that in mind as I do another trial here. Okay? So I'm not changing anything this time. We will just do it again. And I want you to notice what happens at the end. So we have some water here, hot water, again, pouring it into the can. All right, I'm not pouring too much water into the can. Got my fire going here. Let me move this away so you can see that. And if any time you have a question, just comment it, let me know. Myself or the workshop team that's on the chat will do our best to answer the question. How much water you just only need about a tablespoon or so, just enough to cover the bottom of the can. And actually, I'm gonna pour some out. Pour a little bit too much. Okay. So now we want to introduce more energy into this can. We want the water to turn into steam. Okay. I'm using a different can here, so maybe it might not crush. But we'll see how strong air is around this, okay? And there's a really cool video I want to show you at the end, so stay tuned around that. And we'll have a little question and answer period at the end, too. So we're heating the can up. So this is why we need our parents' permission and supervision, okay? This could be quite dangerous. So as we're heating it up, I see some steam coming out. You think it'll implode? Great guess, great guess. So think about what I said just now. Why is there water inside the can after it's imploded? If it's being crushed, doesn't that force all the water out? Why is that? All right, let's give it a try. So I have steam coming out. Turn off the heater. Make sure everyone can see. Ooh. So this can, a little bit more different. It didn't crush because the can is a lot stronger and it seemed to have stuck on the bottom of my pan. Why is that? Why did it get stuck on the bottom of the pan? Let me try to take that out. Did everyone kind of hear that sound? Oh, that sucking noise? Why is that? See, look at all this water that's coming out. Isn't that weird? Why did this can not crush, but just suck all the water from the inside? So this can is stronger, if you can feel it. Well, you can't feel it, I can, but it is stronger. So maybe that's why it didn't crush. But because of that, you could see all the water getting sucked up inside. So let me explain why that happens. And I see some really, really great comments. People are saying it created a vacuum and it made the stick. That is exactly right. Sarah, yeah, like a vacuum. Awesome. There is no air or less air in the can and it made a vacuum. That is exactly right. So we're all on the same page. And that's actually what happens when we drink from a straw. But before that, let me go back to this picture. And if you can see the little blue arrows on the bottom of the water, because what happens is, as I heat it up, like all of you have said, there's less air in there. There's a lower pressure. So when I put it into the water, water actually presses all around us and pushes the water into the can. So let me say that again. When I heat up the water in here, it turns into steam. A lot of the air escapes. And what happens is it creates a low pressure environment. And when I tip it over, it creates a seal. And like many of you said, it creates a vacuum. And just like how a vacuum sucks up stuff, the air, the atmospheric pressure around us pushes the water into the can. And in the same way, that's how it works when we're drinking. We're actually creating a low pressure environment in our mouths when we try to drink a drink. And atmospheric pressure pushes that drink up through the straw, and then we can enjoy our Coke, 7-Up, Sprite, Brisk, all those good things. Okay, so now that we've had that, I want to show you a video by Steve Spangler Science, and he does that with large 55-gallon drums. So I don't have 50 drum up, and now he's putting it into cold water. Okay, and now he's putting more ice on it. He's putting more ice on it to cool it down so that the steam inside will condense. And let's wait for it and see what happens. So as the particles are condensing, they take up less space, and then the air pressure, boom! Wow, crushes that. Isn't that crazy? The power of air, the power of air all around us can do so much work. Thank you so much, everyone, for tuning in. I really enjoyed being able to show you this really fun science experiment. I hope everyone's learned something new. Before I go, we do have our website gearing up online. We have a lot of activities that you can do with your family at home, STEM-related crafts, and also we have online programs for teachers that want to do online learning and professional development. We also have a Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and we will soon have a TikTok. So if you do miss any of these videos, we will try our best to post them up onto our social media sites so you can catch them anywhere else. And I want to end off today by saying what we learned. So we learned that there's three states of matter. There's solid, liquid, and gas. And water was changing states of matter as we heated up and as we took heat away from it and cooling it down. And we also have air pressure, the atmospheric pressure all around us, exerting a force and crushing the can or pushing water into the vacuum. Thank you so much for joining me. If you want to stick around, I have one last video of an actual tanker imploding so you can see that. Wow, crazy. The power of air really all around us. Very awesome. Science is so cool. And now I have a slow motion one if you want to see that. Very slow motion air tanker being crushed. Look at that. You know, we shouldn't underestimate the power of air all around us, atmospheric pressure. Participates in so many things in our lives. Awesome. Cool. So if you have any questions, feel free to leave them on the comments. I will be online for maybe about 10 more minutes or so just to answer any questions you might have about gearing up or about the experiment we did today. So thank you so much for tuning in. Hope everyone has a great day. And remember, keep washing your hands, keep practicing being safe at home and social distancing. Okay, we're gonna do a great job with this and we will come out of it all together. Awesome. Thank you so much, everyone. Bye-bye. Well, I'll be here, but bye to the people that are leaving. What are we doing tomorrow? It's gonna be a surprise. So I want you to tune in tomorrow. Interestingly enough, we will be using some of the same principles that we have that we use today. We're going to be talking about air pressure and states of matter, but we're going to be doing something else, not crushing a can, but something cool. All right, so tune in for that. Andrew asks, what will we learn next? So we'll learn principles that are around the same thing, but you're going to see a different experiment. Okay, and as you learn, we will have different topics that come up as well too, so you can stay tuned to that. So every day we have something new. Can a milk jug do the same thing? Great question. Great question. So have you ever sort of washed a milk jug with warm soapy water and then capped the milk jug and put it in a corner and then throughout the day, you see the milk jug getting crushed? Same thing. You don't need a fire. You don't need to put the milk jug on a flame. If you just wash it with hot water and put the cap on, what happens is the same thing. As it cools, the steam in there condenses and takes up less space, and the milk jug kind of gets crushed by the vacuum. Hopefully that answers your question. Thank you so much for everyone's great comments. Our gearing up camps all canceled. You can check out our website for the most updated status that we have, so feel free to check that. 11 a.m. Pacific time tomorrow. Yes, Kimberly, we're going to be here 11 a.m. tomorrow as well. Let's see. So what about Bernoulli's principle? Great question. So Bernoulli's principle has to do with fluids. It's a little bit more of a complicated thing to explain on a short live stream, but maybe in an experiment down the road, we'll talk a little bit more about Bernoulli's principle and fluid dynamics and pressure. But great question, Andrew. Thank you so much. Sorry if I mispronounced your names, but thank you so much, Mehar, for joining us. I'm glad you learned through this lesson. Can you please explain why the first can imploded? Of course, Suresh. So let me go back to this slide right here. So the first can imploded because what happens is when you're heating up water, creates gas, creates steam. And steam is moving around really fast. And a lot of the steam is escaping. And then when we tilt the can upside down into the water, it cools down the steam. And as steam cools, it forms liquid. And because liquid particles take up less space than solid particles, as we see in this one right here, because liquid particles take up less space, they actually exert less pressure on the sides of the walls. And because of that, because of the less pressure that the liquid on the inside is exerting on the can, air pressure, atmospheric pressure around us, actually is stronger and then crushes the can in doing so. Hopefully that answers your question, Suresh. And is there games or activities on the site? Rachel, great question. There are a lot of activities on the site, and there's a lot of suggestions for things you can do at home. Crafts, games that have to do with science and technology, engineering, lots of great resources we have on there. So feel free to check out our website right there. I'm going to put it up one more time. Who's coming from New Hill? A lot of people representing from New Hill. Awesome. And Sarah, thank you so much for answering that question. Yes, there are lots of activities. Sarah is one of our gearing up instructors. So thank you so much. Oh, milk jugs. So in the East, milk comes in bags. Interesting. What about plasma? Great question. So, let me put it back here. So many of us have heard about the fourth state of matter. What was the trend of the states of matter? So as we introduce more energy, you're going to get a different state of matter. So if you introduce an even higher form of charged particles, that will kind of form plasma. And maybe we will have a demo one day showing some plasma state of matter. But right now, I won't have much of the resources to be able to do so. But I hope that in some way answers your question. And if not, I could address that question in our next stream. If you tune in next time, I can give you some more detailed explanation of what plasma is. Maybe in the beginning of the stream when people are still tuning in, I can take my time to explain that in a little bit more detail. Okay, I'll keep that in the back of my mind. Plasma, awesome. No worries, Suresh. Thank you so much for asking that question. I love your video. Thank you so much, Kevin. Greatly appreciated. Is milk plasma? So milk would be a liquid. Ice cream, kind of a solid, and then when it melts, forms a liquid. So ice cream is just heavy cream or milk with a lot of fat. So when that solidifies, it forms ice cream. So you can see the differences in one material having three different states. So milk on its own is not plasma, milk is liquid. All right, awesome. Well, thank you so much for tuning in to this short 30-minute stream. We're going to try to do this every day, and hopefully the next 30 minutes tomorrow you can learn something new as well. So thank you so much for joining us. Make sure to check out our website. Lots of fun stuff on there. Okay, this is Sam tuning out. Thank you so much for joining me on Gearing Up, and I hope to see you again tomorrow. Okay, bye bye everyone, take care.